Hey guys, Andrew here, and welcome back to another episode of Valhalla. When we last left off, we had met an idol for the first time, and she signed a glass for us, which I don't know if we still have or keeping at the bar. I'm not sure. In any case, it is the 15th today, and the 17th is when our bills due, so we're almost there to the paying of the bills. So, let's see. Boop. All right, what do we got? Some new news in the augmented eye. Neo San Francisco rocked by an earth. Quincy, one more civil death. And is Alice Rabbit a group? Huh. What's this? This is a new app. Kira Mickey blog. Thanks, CG. Or GC. Oh, I love this place. So much energy, so much love. I can feel the optimism in the air. Even after all the struggles, you still came to see me, and I got to experience the loudest and craziest crowd of my whole career. I'm beyond speechless. That said, I'm excited to announce that we'll have a second date in the city. It wasn't easy to set up, but I'm so happy my agency approved it. This is by far our biggest show, and I can't wait to experience it again. See you soon, my darlings. What do I do to relax? It's been very hectic as of late, so I'd like to share with you what I do to relax. Sitting on rooftops, I'm on the road most of the time, so I don't have a specific rooftop to relax on. I feel like I like to feel the breeze and see a beautiful vista. It makes me think about life. Tea cocktails. This is something I can't live without. Mix some tea with vodka, rum, gin, lime, you name any tasty and natural combination, and I'll be all over it. Very careful about getting tipsy before a show, though. I wouldn't like to ruin your evening. Oh. Huh. Tea-like drink. What? See, that's super vague. Mixing tea with vodka, rum, gin, lime, you name it, any tasty and natural combination and all the over. So she just wants a mixed drink. How would I know that a tea cocktail is a mixed drink? I'm not a fucking real-life bartender, crazy woman. Any case, let's head back home, and I guess I haven't met that one yet. I already shopped. I have enough money to pay my bills. That's all that's important. So let's go to work. Thursday, December 15th. Good evening. Oh, hi there. Fuck! A new person already? Man, there's a lot of people. I was not expecting to have to do this many voices at one particular time. Shit. I guess I'll just have to cave in and start doing every dumb voice I can think of under the sun, regardless of if it fits personality or not. So, you, my dear. Let me get some, there we go. You're gonna get the dumb voice, so.
I was expecting the bar to be different before opening hours, but I guess it's just the same tired thing.
Alma?
Ah, Leonidas? Leonidas?
Gillian.
Marcelio.
I stumbled across her on my way in and asked her if she wanted to tag along.
I hope you don't mind.
Sure, make yourself at home. Where's boss? She didn't put the helmet on again, did she? She went out for a bit. I don't know what for, but she'll be back. Alright. Alma, make yourself comfortable while I prepare.
Alright, thanks.
Jukebox. That's fine. Time to mix drinks and change lives.
What was that?
Oh, just something they made me say back in the instruction. It kind of stuck.
Huh. I went to school that made us stand up with our hands in our backs when someone came in. But our habit didn't run them off until high school or so.
Yeah, it's kind of like that. Oh yeah, look at this.
A glass with a signature. I'll assume it's either an autograph or an impromptu medicine recipe.
That Kira Mickey girl came in here yesterday before her concert, actually.
Oh yeah, now I see your name here.
You don't seem very surprised.
I like B-Link more, actually.
The stoic-looking duo, right?
Yep, those. Seems you had a better day than mine yesterday. I had to break up with Damien.
I see. Want a drink?
You don't seem very surprised.
Alma, we've known each other for, a few months now? I'd be interested if those relationships of yours went further than a week or two. You say you broke up, but there's usually not enough time to foster something to break. It's more like, the guy wasn't what I wanted, so I stopped flirting.
You could pretend to be more interested, you know?
Like my mom says, if I don't buy it, it's because I know the product.
Huh. Speaking of buying, do you want a frame?
A frame?
Yeah, for all these pics you have of your boss, the one filling your phone's memory. Some seem sneakily taken at that.
Is that true? What do you care? How the hell did you find that out? So it is true. Shut up.
I'm a hacker, remember? You shouldn't piss off a hacker. Oh, I really like this one of her sleeping in her office. I think I'll copy it.
You...
Hey, can you make me a bad touch before we keep arguing?
Sure. Let's see. Bad touch. Bad touch is 1 and a 2 and a 1 and a 2 and a 1 and a 2 and a 1, 2, 3, 4 on the rocks and mixed. And shabaladoop. Here.
Who gives these drinks their silly names?
Usually the one who registers it. Some people have quite the silly sense of humor.
Like that girl who keeps laughing over this particular drink's name?
Yeah. So, who's Damien again?
The one with the nice car. Sure, he's also the manager at the bank, but that car was what caught my eye.
And what was wrong with him?
Turns out he was a LARPer.
LARP?
Live-action role-playing.
Sounds more like the nickname of some very heavy-handed writer or a military organization. What did he role-play as?
Have you heard of the Woodstock Fairs?
Those events where people barely dress, stink, roll in the mud, and fuck in the open?
Those are the hippies, yeah. He frequents those, and it's something I'd rather not deal with, at all. If I stayed with him, I'd eventually have to. I mean, I need to support my partner in what he does, but if it's something like that...
You see, that's the problem right there. You say breaking up like you had something formal, but most of the time you're still getting to know him. Think about it. Have you ended your longest lasting relationship for things like those?
Okay, sorry for not using the right word or whatever, but I'm still sorely disappointed. At least I'm trying to get some action. When was the last time you spent the night with someone else?
Last night.
Your cat doesn't count.
A year ago, it was messy.
See? I mean, I have no idea how you deal with that. If I were you, I would have pushed Fuckboy over there into a closet ages ago.
Fuckboy? People have different needs and priorities.
Yes, but don't you miss having the warmth of someone else by your side? Using them as a pillow, mixing your perfume with theirs, putting your head on their chest, listening to them breathe as they pet your head, dozing off knowing that they're there watching you, protecting you.
Blech. Can't do Kermit voice for that long. Huh.
Joe?
Huh. Anything I can make you to shut up and drink?
I'll have you know that my Uncle Warren taught me ventriloquism when I was 12. Drinking won't stop me from talking, or making tasteless puns for Aunt Rosa. Still, get me something weird, would you?
Huh, ventriloquism. Weird. A weird drink?
Yeah, something different. Experimental. Uncommon.
Oh, let's see. What? That's weird. What? A fedora? With perfume and a plum? Can you just put that in? How does that work? You just put this in here and... That's it. Plum fume. What? Wait, what's a weird drink by type? Promo drinks? Boomlight? I'm just gonna try this. Here you go.
Nope, this looks pretty common to me. I'll take it anyways, but no tip for this one.
You know, your orders are weird today.
They are?
Yeah, usually the first thing you ask for is a brantini, and then something like a cobalt velvet or something similar.
Well, I sometimes feel like I need something different, you know?
Something tells me part of the reason you left this Damien is because he was too deep into routine.
Maybe.
Hey, speaking of routines, as a hacker, what's your opinion on the whole Alice Rabbit thing? That's the silence of somebody who just heard something stupid. Stupid enough to warrant the speech that they prepared just for the occasion like this.
As always, very perceptive of you. You know, decades ago, there was this group of people that hacked simple sites with an agenda. Can't remember what they used to call themselves, I just remember it was just petty vandalism.
Heh, get it? Anonymous?
Anyway, everyone that participated started using the same name. They wanted to create this, anonymous anarchist identity.
Anonymous? Yeah.
The whole Alice Rabbit thing, that is a logical conclusion to that. It's what happens when that idea reaches its breaking point and it goes mainstream.
God, I cannot do that voice for a long period of time.
It is no longer a group, but an individual. An untouchable entity watching from the shadows, monitoring and judging everything everyone does. Observing, tolerating, no one but itself. A lot of bullshit for what it's essentially a pet that press made up. The antithesis of your usual boogeyman, if you must.
So you don't think such a person exists?
I don't know. Don't care. I mean, we have seen the actions of such an entity. But it might be anything. Individual, a group, an AI. That's not taking into account all the copycats and pranksters using the name.
Ugh. God.
So, Alex Rabbit is that thing that exists, but it's also really muddied overall. There's something else that worries me, though. That kind of story always catches the attention of kids and such. They start trying to hack stuff without knowing the risk of consequences. Imagine if suddenly a group of tweens broke into this bar and started asking for drinks. That's how it feels for me, and it's thanks to that damned Alice Rabbit thing.
Shit, a long speech. Hold on, I'm gonna take some water. Whew. I see.
Enough about that. There's a more pressing matter at hand.
There is?
Yeah, you've been delaying my invitations for hanging out sometime for too long.
Oh, that.
You hate me that much, dear? Does my presence make you rather uncomfortable?
No, I...
At this rate, I might just crash by your apartment. That way you can't just say no. Maybe I'll also crash for the night. We could have a sleepover, braid our hair, tell stories all night, shower together. You know you need some human warmth in that place.
Your tits alone would fill my entire bathroom.
Man, you react too nonchalantly. It's no fun. React a little bit. Let me tease you for a second.
I refuse.
In all seriousness, though, any particular reason you keep turning down my invitations? I mean, it's not a date. I just want to have a conversation with you outside these four walls.
I'm not a morning person. I registered for a night shift precisely to avoid waking up early.
The earliest I've asked you out is 10 a.m., you know.
That's early morning by my standards. I mean, it's not that I don't want to hang out, it's just that I don't want to wake up early.
You are hopeless. Anyway, I'm gonna need another drink here. Big Brantini?
Finally, that's the Alma I know. The order was, I'd like to say a rabbit? Wow, you really trying to quiz me here? Trying to make me, like, take the training wheels off and going like, alright, you gotta know what you're here for now. Brantini. Ugh. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And 1. All aged and mixed. Yeah. Bow. Success. Here.
You know, Brantini is such a weird name.
It was originally supposed to replicate the Martini. Problem is, the BTC got a hold of a brand of vermouth that was named after a certain automobile company. So, on a weird whim, they changed the name.
I see.
You know, I was wondering.
Yeah?
Don't you worry about what the people you work for might be doing with the information you provide?
Not really.
You don't?
Do you worry about what happens when people leave this place drunk?
Not really. Most of the time.
Well, neither do I.
Why should you? Do you get people drunk?
Some say my beauty is intoxicating. But, that's besides the point. I get my payment, do my job, and forget about the whole thing.
You make your job sound so easy.
Once you understand that, or what precautions to take, it's no problem. And I've always found my job fun. However, most of my contracts are consultancy-based gigs. It's not like every day is a thrill.
Do you meet with your clients, or...?
I don't. It's always from behind as many filters as I can manage. I remember I once did a job where I had a couple of kids relaying letters.
Ugh, that was a hard one to say with a Kermit voice. For security reasons, right?
Actually, because that way I lose a lot less time. I don't have to deal with the clients hitting on me or pestering me after the job's done. I also don't have to lose time providing my worth because big boobs equal small brain or some shit like the...
I cannot do a full sentence like that with current voice. That's my limit, and I need to overcome it.
I mean, protecting my identity is one of the reasons, but a few times I've shown myself. They weren't even risky or dangerous jobs, just run-of-the-mill security checks. I don't know, maybe I need to show... Is it a disheveled nerd or something?
God damn, I gotta let my voice, like loosen up again before I can tense it up again.
I don't know. Maybe I need to show up as a disheveled nerd or something. Give them what they expect to see. Or I just don't show up and save myself the trouble. Why all the questions?
Just things I've been curious about and always forget to ask. So many Alice Rabbit headlines have me wondered about the hacking business, too.
Oh, I remember to ask you things next time, then. Well, I'll take my leave now. See ya.
Take care. Someone new? Hello, sugar. Ow. Oh. Damn it, why do you question mark? Come on, man. I hate the question mark thing in visual novels, because then I'm trying to read and I can't think of the voice. Here we go again. Hello, Mr. Donovan. My poor throat! It's gonna die. Well, if we're about to do Mr. Donovan's voice, I'm gonna need a breather and a cigarette to get in character. With that said, I'm gonna go ahead and say thank you guys for watching. If you'd like to see it, go ahead and click subscribe. As always, leave a comment in the comment section below telling me why the worst Valhalla play I've ever seen before. As always, thank you guys for watching. See you guys next time, and
bye!